folks, Quillopolis here, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play City Skylines. We are in Quillopolis. Been a little while since we played this. Got busy for a few days there, but it's really nice to be back. Now, there's probably going to be a bit more obsessing over this area because of the traffic. I ran a little bit of a test off screen here to see if an off-ramp here would make too much of a difference, but it looks like a lot of the traffic here is making a left turn, and what happens is it's resulting in a bit of backup here because the intersection is a bit more complex. What I'm going to go ahead and do is go and put a one-way that connects up this neighborhood here so that some of these vehicles can use a slightly different intersection. Of course, this is going to create more intersections, and, you know, more intersections is often not the solution. But I think that in this case, it's actually going to save simplify the traffic at this intersection quite a bit and ultimately improve traffic flow pretty dramatically. We've got plenty of water here. It looks like there's actually a building that's not quite covered by a water grid. Look at that. And we could use some more sewage outflow. So let's go ahead and get some of that going on over here. The poop must flow. We got to make sure that it's going all right. Boom. Good. Excellent. All right. Other than that, I would really like to continue to develop things. You know, you always have to do it sort of in stages. And I probably shouldn't still... Whoa. Oh, that was the autosave blink. Right, I forgot about that. You always want to grow it a bit in stages so that you can see what effect your changes have before you just continue to make changes in bulk. Where's the actual line end? There it is. But I think it's time. I think it's okay for us to go ahead and do a little bit more expansion. We did develop... Oh, yeah, I can't quite do that. But if I do this and do that... We have developed this area a little bit more recently. The train system is going well. We've actually got a loop in the train system that goes all the way around. And I don't think there are any traffic jams in the train lines anymore. Because I think having enough space here has really contributed to quite a bit. We still have this circle exchange, which really I don't think can handle super, super high capacity. But for now is running okay, and it certainly looks very pretty. Traffic here is perfectly bearable. Again, this sort of traffic exchange may not handle unlimited amounts of traffic either, but it looks neat. And we can see here, this intersection has dramatically cut down on its traffic, which means the traffic that's coming off the highway here can flow into the city a lot better. Yeah, there's a bit of a pause here, but I don't think that's as much of an issue. I don't think there's going to be less throughput here than there was here, and what this does is it makes it so that any traffic that's coming in here that's not going to this train station can flow in easier, because that's the thing. A lot of this traffic is going to this train station, and we're slowing down sort of all the traffic, and now that's going to be less of an issue. So we have a pair of train stations there. We've got another one over there, which is good. Demand for an industry is still relatively high. Now, of course, I could go and simply build up quite a lot of office space. Office space, of course, doesn't really generate much in the way of traffic, but, you know, that doesn't seem like fun. So what I think I'm going to do is build yet another train station right over here and sort of fill this area with a bit more industry. And I think that that would be pretty enjoyable. And then after that, we really are going to be done with a lot of our industrial core. It just feels like it would sort of make sense for there to be a lot of industry in this area overall. So what I'm going to do, I'm just trying to think that, depending on how I want to offer up some loops and things. Because, and this still annoys me a little bit, if you want to put down a train station, you can't just hook it up to a track. You've got to have a road. I'm trying to decide where it is, and it should sort of be on its own little crossing. So I think what I'm going to do, and I can't remember how people enter these train stations. Right, okay. So in this case, yeah, they'd enter on the right and then exit just after that, I think. Yeah, that's it. But if the train station goes in the opposite direction, which is what would be happening here, we want our one-way feeding our train station to go in this direction. This simplifies the intersection just a little bit. So I'm going to do that. I think that'll be okay. I am concerned about one thing here. So this is what I'm trying to do. And then I want to have a dedicated set of roads feeding in here. I just need to make sure, of course, that my rail here is long enough. And yeah, it should be. Looks a little odd there. What I can do is have it come off that way, then go into the curvy tool, and then have it come in like that. There we go. Now, if this train wanted to... Oh, that's a passenger traffic. No, it's not. If we wanted a train that could go here, we have to make sure that it's got a bit of a loop. Let's see here. I mean, this is quite good if you want to go east or west. I wonder, can I connect more rail right in here? Is there any way we can get that to fit? Let's use the straight tool over here. Looks like the answer is no. We can't have it branch in from the side, although I don't think that that is going to connect the way that we want. That would, though. I mean, it makes a slightly more complicated intersection, but it lets us not get into the situation where we have train tracks that are too close to one another. And what I'm going to do here, yeah, I'm actually going to go over and over, then switch back to the curve tool. And have it come in where? I might be able to get it to come in right over there. Let's see here. Will it let me build the connection I want? It will. Lovely. There we are. I mean, obviously our rail's taking up quite a bit of space. I probably could shrink this down a little. But I don't know. Now, can they make that corner? They can. And what's important is that every little piece of road is long enough that we're not going to get much in the way of weird, wonky traffic. Okay. So now, what we want is to figure out how we want to feed this neighborhood to the rest of our little grid here. You know, like the highway connections and whatnot. Well, let's see. And do we want to allow it to go in either direction here? We could branch off this highway and have it connect there. It connects here. I'm just wondering, if we want to go from this area heading north, what's the easiest way to do that? I guess it'd have to get onto the highway here, come over here, then go that way, which is not the end of the world. I'm just trying to wonder if, like, we want to create some sort of connection over here, if that would be good for traffic, bad for traffic. I guess it would be okay. We're going to end up with some pretty crazy interchanges here. But if I were to take my highway, let's see, an actual on-ramp over here. This connection's not too bad. Could put it in here. I'm worried about having like too many sort of on-ramps and weavings and things. It might be okay. Tell you what, let's build a little bit of a road structure. Let's go with some conventional roads to just form our little area here. Although, do I want one-ways and things for this? Maybe. And do I want anything to come off there? I don't really need anything to come off here because cars coming from this way. Whoa, that is quite the backup over here. Hello. Now, this is one of the built intersections that's pretty minimal because it's the one line, although really, it's this structure that's slowing everything down. Where the hell are all these cars going? Actually, let's pause to make it a little easier. I don't want that. I want this traffic query tool. Right. So this looked neat, but it's obviously not functional in any way whatsoever. This intersection here is mostly what's slowing things down. I think it would be much, much stronger if we're going to use these two lanes, which we know are not fantastic. If instead, we came off directly into it like that. We can do the same thing on the other side. Although there's not much of a traffic buildup on the other side, so it's really far from the same amount of criticalness. And what I'm hoping here is that we'll evenly split things between the two lanes. Traffic will split nicely. Actually, this would be an excellent candidate for a six lane. Actually, do we even just want it to be a one-way? I think the answer is yes, in which case just having it be a highway connection would be the strongest. Really? It decides to flip my one-way partway through? There we go. Because now hopefully it'll use all three lanes correctly. Still got nice speed coming here off the highway. no traffic light whatsoever. Bit of a sharp corner, so they slow down maybe a little bit. But other than that, it should flow into the city a lot better. We lost some of our prettiness here, which is too bad, but yeah, that's a bad backflow. We're going to come back here in a few minutes. This will take several minutes to clear up. Meanwhile, it might actually be hurting our traffic flow in a fair bit. Okay, back to this issue. So yeah, so any cars coming that's on this highway that want to get into this block can easily do it here. So we really just have to worry about a highway connection on this end of things. So I guess we'll make a little bit of a trumpety kind of something or other. We probably will do just fine with just the on-ramp, off-ramp kind of thing. So if we pull off like that, for one. And we don't know what we're going to connect into. Maybe actually just a six-lane road. I think that's going to be fine. So, create something like that. And then, I should really be measuring these out. But let's say we just do that. How do we work this connection? It's been a while since I've built some of these things. Well, this one really wants to get to the other side. I mean, space already occupied. Oh, because of the elevation. Interesting. Okay. Well, so I guess we're going up one more level here. A little further back. It's going to be a little awkward to connect, potentially, because of the slopes involved. Although, we could just connect over here. Takes up a fair bit more room, but punches things a little deeper into our little configuration. And that's not really a bad thing. Same thing here, we can pull off. Can we get this to go the way I want? Yeah, that's sort of what I was going for, actually. And obviously we'll need a way out, but it doesn't have to be in the same place. It could be as simple as something like that. It's usually bad form to have things merge on the inside lane, or the leftmost lane, but I think in this case we'll make an exception, and I think it'll be okay. Meanwhile, population's dropping a little bit, and we've got a fair bit of demand for different things, but I think that we're actually in pretty damn good shape. Let's do that. Bring you like this. And we will fill in the gap there, and do that. Okay. We will need power. Probably we can get it to sort of auto-connect in some fashion. But for now, let's go ahead and actually just run some cables here. Higher. Let's just do one of those and then work something out. Alright, it's got power, it's got water. It'd be very interesting to see if anything uses it already. Most likely not. And then we're going to create some, I guess we're going to create some intersections is what's going to happen. That's going to be fine. We don't need, like, you know, maximum density. We can leave a little bit of green space from time to time. Believe it or not, I do kind of like nature. Well, not in real life. In real life, nature, keeping nature out is why we build houses. Alright, we'll do something like that, and then zone this whole thing as industrial. And we're going to watch some of this traffic get pretty crazy over here, I suspect. A lot of demand for it. It fills up right away. We'll give them a little bit of a fire and police stations. We might want to give them their own clinic here as well. There we go. No public transit at this time, but maybe we can make an adjustment for that. And yeah, because of the demand on industry, it should fill in really, really quickly. Already we've got a fire here? Really? I think I just built a fire station. I mean, this thing had been running for a little while outside of the grid of fire protection, so I guess it's not unbelievable that it might already catch fire. A lot of trucks. There we go. And we have saved it. Lots of upgrades coming through. And we can probably sneak a road, or snake a road through here, actually. If I take this, I have to be a little bit... There we are. Like that. I'll just pre-place it. I have to be a little careful about what kind of traffic might flow on there as opposed to something else. Don't want this to become too crazy. But it should flow, and the trains should use this. Both inside the city, but also just to specifically service this one little industrial area. Let's build up a little bit more over here. We still have a lot of commercial demand. So ultimately, get that going like that, and then the idea with this road, which we'll have to make a quick little break in our power situation here, we'll need to connect up there. And hopefully not carry... You know what? Nope. I want you to be straight. Hopefully... No! God damn it! Not carry too much traffic. Is what I'm trying to get out here. Power... where... Do I still want to run this? Yeah, it's fine. Hopefully we can get something less awkward there soon. Okay, and here, I mostly just want a bunch of commercial. Since there's demand for it, and it should actually get fed in from the industrial areas pretty well. Now, whether they'll have enough customers is a whole other question. They're not super accessible from the highway. Although, you know, this area here can go. They're far from that accessible from the highway. Also a bit of a backup here. It's mostly coming in. I don't think it's cripplingly bad. I think it'll just sort of come and go in bits. There's always been some sort of bad traffic there. It actually might be interesting to see if any of it gets alleviated by the fact that we've got a bit of an area over here. We might take some more of the train traffic off the road. We might give people a slightly alternate route. You have to be worried because sometimes, you know, having more interconnections actually just leads to more traffic. Especially when you've got ways for people to get somewhere without using a highway. That can lead to something bad sometimes. We're going to go ahead and drop an incinerator. I don't know, like right in the middle of this area, actually. That's going to be fine. And a crematorium as well. We can put it over here so it can leave this area and hit the highway relatively easily. Alright, that's still coming in very well. Population is mostly stable, sort of bouncing up and down. We haven't built a residential area in quite some time. Also, that's a lot of dead bodies. Now, our actual death care... We've got tons of crematorium capacity. Are they just all stuck here? Anyway, let me, for the sake of ease... put a crematorium over here, although that's hardly the solution. Most likely, my hearses are just stuck in traffic somewhere. I mean, certainly there are a few places with some backups, although this is not a massively long backup. Let's check this one over here. Okay, this one is still massively long, which is not great, and this is most likely where a lot of those hearses are stuck. Well, there's a hearse there, right there as an example. Are they not able to flow through fast enough? Not very many people making a right turn at all. If I upgraded this road segment to the six lanes. Okay, people could use the right lane now to go straight through, so let's do that. Because, yeah, no one's using this right lane because it wasn't a forward one. They could only make right turns, and that's a pretty low demand thing. So this should help feed these cars in a lot easier, get rid of some of this backlog, which is still absolutely redonkulous. Might still take a few minutes to clear off. Like, this might actually be a perfectly fine configuration. and it's just going to take some time. Traffic is actually flowing through here pretty well. In fact, if it wasn't for this corner turning things around, we'd even get more flow through. So I think this line of traffic is going to go away pretty quickly now. If we find out where it sort of ends, it's right around here. Let's just watch the mouse. It should move over time. Although, there's still a lot of traffic that wants to come in this direction. Now, a fair amount of it... yeah. No, there you go. You can see it just shrink away. Okay, yeah. Yep. A lot of it is actual cars, though. Which means we could, with the help of public transit, maybe solve things. Unfortunately, it doesn't go back far enough. It doesn't show me where they come from. And we do have subways and things all over the place, don't we? There's subways here. Most of the city should be connected, indeed. And then, actually... Oh, I didn't realize it was the same list here. Oh, these are buses. Do we have subways? I don't remember this thing. Can I... I don't have subways in the city. That's right. Is it? That is right, because I was... I don't know, like a thematic thing? I was trying to avoid it because of reasons. So, it's possible a subway would help things, although we'd still have the bus lines. But this traffic jam is still shrinking. If we just wait long enough, it will be eliminated. If we didn't have this be a sharp corner, if we sort of angled things a little bit differently, it would go a little faster. We could upgrade this to sort of a three-lane thing, but I still think most cars would end up going in this rightmost lane. They might split up a little bit, which would help a little. But I still think the traffic jam is shrinking. We just have to wait for it. I might be wrong. Maybe it's not moving back as far as I thought. I guess for the sake of argument, we can do that and see if people start using more lanes. And they are. A little bit more. So now when these guys get the green light, more stuff should get through. Not much more, but maybe a little more. Yeah, see, look at this. They're still mostly just using that right lane, which is exactly what I expected. Maybe given enough time, some of this traffic, because it's old traffic, so they still had the old pathing, it's possible more people will use more lanes, but I think most people are trying to get in the right lane to make that right turn, just because of reasons. And that's okay. Mostly we just have to wait there. Water shortage. Indeed. We go. Speaking of traffic backups, look at that. Most people going right, not necessarily all of them. This might also be a good candidate to broaden. I mean, I don't like to just, you know, throw bigger roads at things all the time. And actually, especially with the extra intersections over here, we might benefit, and in fact, I think we would, is instead of connecting there... Even though it means a little less real estate to play with. Because instead if we connected there. I think we're still fine with just the one and one there. This cuts back on one intersection. And makes these... It eliminated two really, really short little road segments, which are always bad for you. And if given enough time, these guys might split up, so. Quite a bit of cars going this way, which is interesting. Are they trying to make some sort of U-turn? No, they're making a right. I don't know why they wouldn't just go straight. And speaking of, we might want to one-way this. Or actually, so we've got the six lanes here and here. Really, this is the bit that might maybe should have been the six lane. But there's surprisingly few cars going that way. We'll come back. We're not going to mess around with that one too much. And I don't like making big sweeps, but we really should, you know, just block out some huge new residential areas. How's the traffic here? Still really, really bad. Let's build an area over here, though. Mostly residential. Let's pre-lay out some roads to follow this curve, because I think it'll look nice if we do that. Let's use the six lanes with the trees to try to make something big and impressive. So start like that. So I suppose we could start a little closer. Oh, I got the arc tool. That's why it's not working the way I expected. Back up a little bit here. Okay. So yeah, we'll lay this initial bit out and then figure out how it's supposed to connect to everything else. Now, by having these curved roads, we're not really going to have, like, maximum density, because anytime you have a curve, of course, you get a little bit of gap in your zoning. I mean, not just this way, but also between the blocks along the side of the road, because they're not, it's not a straight edge. And then sometimes you end up with a little something like that. That's okay, because we can stick some trees in there. Yeah, let's connect up the ends. That. Now I'm worried I'm a little close to the road, but let's see what we can do. On the bright side, the traffic will flow along this pretty quickly and easily. I think I'll do is I'll build one little area over here. Minimize the connection, but not eliminate them completely. And actually, this would be a good place for the traffic to maybe come in and then split. The downside to this is everyone would go here, where we could have a couple. No, I think we just want the one. So let's go ahead and let's start with a simple one to come off of this bit. Can't end up with the thing that I'm looking for. There we go. And then from the other side, we actually could just feed over here, just split that up a little bit, if we did something like come on. No, we're gonna have to go over. Merge down there, and then from the other side. So that gets us out of the neighborhood into there, and then from here we can do something like... Oh, I wonder if it's possible. Most likely not. Oh. Right there. Slope too steep. A bit weird, but I'm curious to see how that might work. It's a very simple set of intersections, and it splits the traffic between, like, the both sides of the highway into different sections of our little block here. Anyway, let's get down some housing. That'll be residential. I'm gonna put some offices here, because they're not quite as worried about the road. These houses might complain about noise. We'll see how it goes. We'll drop some more offices on this side. And over here. So what I want to do is put... commercial in there because we've got demand for it. Actually, yeah, let's go ahead and do it that way. And then, oops, more housing, but not right there. Well, that's not one block no matter what we do, so never mind. This, though, hang on, should actually be offices because it's next to some residential. And maybe same thing over here. Just put in a little gap in things. Okay. Let's get some water and power out there. Do-do-do. The other issue with these irregular blocks, a little harder to organize the water. Well, that's not true. I mean, the water could be on an actual grid, but it feels good when it mostly follows the road, since that's kind of sort of how it works in real life. Now, how do I want to get power out to this block? Well, I mean, I can just run it this way. I really don't like power lines. They look dumb. So I'm always looking for ways to avoid things. But we can at least start with that and then figure the rest out afterwards. We'll have to wait for these buildings to pop in before everything is connected by power, but that's okay. We will be able to ameliorate things a little bit if we drop in a few parks just to speed things up. First of all, we want a few to just make these people happier. But then we can also use it to push the power along, as I often do. It minimizes how many buildings need to pop in. I'd like a park that doesn't require... So we've got these little ones. That minimizes how many zones we're occupying. There we go. That one might work. What is this one that I'm putting down? Oh, the agricultural fields. No, I don't want that. Got a skate park. There we go. It only interferes with houses on one side, which I like. And then over there. Okay. There we go. Now we'll just wait for some buildings to come in. We'll keep an eye on the traffic. We should probably get some services over on this end of things too. Let's give them a full hospital because this area will grow quite a bit, actually. Crematorium. Again, a full fire station. And a full police station. Also, schools. There you go. I'm going to fill this area with residential things. We've got pretty major roads. I think people should be able to mostly get around pretty well. How's our overall power generation? It's on the verge of running out, so let's go and drop some more in our little lake. Where's our turbine lake? There it is. Right over here. And just keep trying to tuck them in there. Okay, should be more than good enough. Still have lots of people complaining about dead bodies in a variety of places. Number of deceased is going up pretty dramatically. How about the number of sick? We only have 200 sick people, which is not much. So we don't have like a big zombie apocalypse. The problem that we have, actually there's missing crematoriums over here. Not that that's really going to make much of a difference, but I guess there were graveyards over here, but... the problem is mostly going to be that hearses are stuck in traffic. But let's go ahead and plop down a few more just to make sure. And is there any other area that's not properly covered for death care? Yeah, actually. Again, they might have had cemeteries at some point. I may legit have very poor coverage here. Normally I just blame traffic because, well, normally that's correct. Like, if you have traffic problems, then you're going to have problems with everything else. But we may have simply not have enough crematoriums here. Now, it still does the thing where the crematoriums don't necessarily just service what's closest to them, but it still helps to have them spread out. Anyway, we have run way over time here. I'm definitely going to put a break in this video. Thank you very much for watching another episode of a Let's Play Cities Skylines, and I will see you next time.